once back in year 2000, I was commissioned to do a sculpture at Dumas in direct cement. So me and another artist assisting me, we gathered all the relevant materials and started our drive for Dumas. It was a lovely monsoon morning. And while we were working in Dumas, there were a few kids playing around. They were very curious as to what was happening because we were working in cement and making a sculpture out of it. During one of the breaks, we decided to have a walk to a nearby tea shop and have a tea. And few guys followed us. And I saw few kids murmuring something and pointing out to me and said, "Joni ketlo amir mistri che. Ketli moti gaadi lein aave che." This incident, besides being so sweet, also points towards the lack of awareness of art in our region, and for that matter, majority of India. But are we strangers to art? We are an ancient civilization, and by far the richest in heritage and culture. We are known for our bold artworks and vibrant colors. We had amazing art schools with their own languages in medieval era, and yet there wasn't a binary or a signing on an artwork system. So there were no artists as such, they were artisans. But we were a culture that lived in and around art, be it our festivals, our costumes, our turbans, our footwear, our accessories that we used traditionally. So why did we deviate from having art around us as public art? We have seen many commemorative figurative sculptures, or what we may call murtis, in public art or as public art. But why didn't we open up to abstract art or distortion in art, or for that matter, modern art? Our galleries, they tutor us to cater to the most elite. If ever you have come across any brochure or a catalog of an art gallery or any show, they will try to dig out the toughest words from the vocabulary and put it there. Elite class may fancy that, but that distances the common man away from art. And a common man opts to go to any other source of entertainment but to an art gallery. And that's where public art is important. Public art does not discriminate between caste, creed, cadre, or even your level of education. It's for everybody. For example, a famous sculpture at Chicago. It's made by an Indian-born British artist, Anish Kapoor, which may be perceived as a droplet of mercury, which reflects Chicago's skyline in it. It has been seen that most of the people who go to Chicago, they go and see that place. It has been immensely photographed, covered by movies, we have that in advertisements, and it has a huge economic value also, which public art deserves. As an artist, I was and I am a learner. And I have never-ending craving for it. But today, here I stand, not for my sketches or my drawings. I stand here for the art that I do for masses. Masses who do not visit art galleries. I have worked in almost all the materials and mediums what visual arts have to offer. But I had a choice to make, and my choice is making a monumental quality and a scale. When I'm making a sculpture, it is for a common man in India here. As we see kids growing, they must have public art around them. Only then would they be able to perceive, or they can at least dream to follow any creative faculty. And all the civic bodies or authorities should curtail themselves from having too much of advertisements or branding on the circles and on the islands in the name of public art. We are all so proud of our city. It's so beautiful. And we are also proud of Surat Municipal Corporation for having done a brilliant job where infrastructure is concerned. So they have imbibed such a wonderful infrastructure with art now. The beauty of public art is that the cities are known with that. For example, if I say New Delhi, Qutub Minar or Red Fort will pop up in your head. If I say Mumbai, it'll be Gateway of India or VT station. For that matter, Ahmedabad has a logo of Sidi Said Ni Jali. Someone said it very well once, that we only appreciate art in absence of it. I would love to see the name of Surat as Art Smart City and India as Art Smart Country. Thank you so much.